Good boy! Part two of the cymbal cleaning deal. I pull out the rest of my cymbals. This, I thought it was a 20-inch crash ride, but it's a 19. I just checked it. Been so long ago since I bought them all. This is a newer thin crash. It's a 14-inch that I got. And see, they put these ink stamps on them. And if you clean them with that cleaner, it's going to take that off. But it's still got the original Zildjian stamp in the metal. There it is over there. I don't know if y'all can see it, but that's it. And see how the bottom side is real, real shiny on this one? You can get that back by using the polish after you clean them good with that cleaner, and get one of these wheels and put it in your battery drill motor, and you can get that mirror shine back in there. But you talk about hard work. Boy, that's pain in the butt. Just hitting them with the cleaner is good enough. These need to be cleaned. This is a 15-inch, what's left of a rock crash set that I had. I had two sets like this, and I sold one set, or I sold the top and the bottom to one set. I think this is the bottom part of that rock crash. I don't really remember, but it's a real heavy cymbal, I know that. And I actually took and drilled some holes in the bottom set when I sold my Ludwig Octoplus set, and it made it have a tighter chick. But I didn't like the rock ones because they were so heavy. They were hard to make them click together fast. 14 inches is a good size. That's what these are right here. I believe these are Zildjian's, what they call New Beat, that they sold back in the 70s. I think this one's a 17-inch medium crash. This is a 18-inch medium crash. Over there. 18-inch medium crash. And a 16-inch thin crash. And then that ride over here is a 22 medium ride. Hitting on it with a hunk of metal too, so it makes it give it a livelier sound. I didn't know this, but somebody had said the correct name. I call them by sock cymbal. Well, that's, I guess you're playing with your socks. I'm not really sure. I did some research on it. Originally they were called clangers, and they were hit off of a beater attached to the bass drum's pedal, and they was on a little rod that would, I don't know how in the hell they worked, but that was way, 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 way back. And then they came out with what was called a low boy, which was a sock cymbal that was real low like this. And then they finally evolved into the modern day hi-hat. And they've experimented with putting rivets in them and all kind of different stuff. Did you know a drum kit got a clutch on it? Yes, sir. This is a clutch right here. You can adjust that clutch to where it's slipping like it is now. So when you're playing double bass, the sock cymbals stay closed. And when you want to set the clutch, okay, and you see that's a lighter, you can respond faster with your foot on that than with those heavy 15-inch cymbals, heavier cymbals. And they used to sell them with holes drilled in the bottom of them. I experimented because I didn't like the way them 15s responded. It was so much air coming out from them, they didn't give a good chick sound like these. They didn't have a nice crisp chick. You'd hear a whoosh, kind of a sloppy chick sound. Not chickens, not babies. Not babes, I'm talking about chick, 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 chick. That kind of sound. That's got a crisper chick sound to them. And yeah, it got adjustments where you can tilt this cymbal on the bottom. And they got an adjustment up underneath there. and it's set. You see how they lean in a little bit? See the groove wide over here than it is over there? That's to help the air escape quicker. Give you a quicker chick chick sound. So, and again, warning, that cleaner is going to take that ink stamp off. If you want to save your ink stamps, you better not use that cleaner, and you better not put this on there either, because it's going to take it off. So we're whooping on it with a stick. You can see right there on the Z. I also got this as a hunk of Vetus or Zildjian brass. Yeah, it's made by Vetus Zildjian. And you hit it with a stick, and it makes a oscillating kind of sound. My fingers softening like a stick, boy. There. This old heavy hunk of bristle. You hang it from something and whoop on it, kind of like a triangle. Hang it off your nose and whoop it. That ought to cover it. Now I'll play them all. Yeah, that song was by Led Zeppelin. You know, that beat was by Led Zeppelin, Fool in the Rain. And I didn't play it exactly right. There's another 16th note in there that's done with the chick on the sock cymbal, a boom shkatkapak, like that, if you listen to it real close. And I had to go back and make sure that I was playing it right, and I noticed that, and I just didn't do it. Get too old to remember every damn thing. I mean, shit. I must have learned that when I was 18 years old. That's a lot of years ago, yeah, boy. So we'll put these back in the cymbal vault and store them until I decide to clean them. Well, a little hardware here to fill. Where you done went? Come out of there, boy! You non-union don't make me go get my magnet. Son of a bitch. Garbage. Little washer. Goes on with the nut. Put the top on the case. Keep the grandkids out. Cut their foot off. Drop a cymbal on your toe. You ain't gonna have a toe. If you barefooted. Or even wearing tennis shoes. Cymbals is heavy. They're expensive too. I think I paid $150 for that 22-inch ride back in the 70s. I was looking, them suckers are like over 200 and something dollars now, close to $300 for a 22-inch. Zildjian, anyway. And that ain't the cheap line. Back then they had the cheap line, they just had this line. Now they done come up with all these other different flavors. Cheaper ones, beginners, which I guess is good. I had to bite the bullet and get the good stuff. Oh, don't any of y'all be stupid ass, what's a triangle? This is a triangle. Come and get it. Oh yeah, something I didn't mention. At the factory when they polishing them cymbals, they got a big old polishing wheel like that big around, and they hold that cymbal on that wheel with a compound of polishing juice. Look like car polish, okay, but it's made for brass. I got a different kind of polish for stainless, a different one for aluminum. And they polish it like that, with that big ass wheel. And it's a whole lot easier than that little bitty wheel, I'll tell you that. It don't take them as long. So that's how you get your factory sheen back to them. You have to use a wheel. And it's gonna take you about over an hour for one side of one cymbal. Trust me, I done been there, done that. I'm glad I found that cleaning juice. It works fine. I ain't going no further. Yeah, I forgot I had this. A big old sheet of it's a big old piece of sheet brass. Sound like a gong or a bell, don't it? Bang a gong, get it on.